Welcome to the second edition of our 95th anniversary collections tour. This one is on witch hazels. I'm Mary Tipping, Scott Arboretum curator and plant recorder, and witch hazel lover. As you will see, many of our witch hazels are in full bloom right now, so this is the perfect time for videographer Becky and I to be out looking at these beautiful specimens. We have over 56 different varieties of witch hazels in our collection, and we will be adding more over the next few years. And speaking of the witch hazels, there's something really important about their flowering period. If you stage it correctly, if you pick the different species and varieties, you can have witch hazel flowers from the fall, then again through late January into March. And so Hamamelis virginiana is the first to bloom, and that's in the fall. And then starting in very late January, well, it's really depending on the weather and the temperature outside, you have your Hamamelis mollis, Hamamelis ex intermedia, Hamamelis vernalis, followed by Hamamelis japonica. I forgot to mention Hamamelis oveta, which also blooms around the same time as the vernalis. So pick one of each different species and or variety and decorate your landscape with them. So here's one of our success stories. This particular cultivar is Aurora, and I'm calling it a success story because this plant was located about 700 feet away at our science center, and we needed to do some construction at the corner of the science center 3 or 4 years ago. So our gardening crew dug this plant by hand and relocated it to the slope at Whittier Hall. Now notice with Aurora, the petals are straight, but they have a little bit of a twist to them. And more importantly, which I find absolutely fascinating, is how the petal starts very light at the tip, and then the color graduates darker, sort of a peach, and then darker to a little bit of a burnt orange, and then it ends in the calyx. See that four kind of petaled structure right in the center of the flower? That's called a calyx, and it's actually very, very showy, and on this particular variety, it's a beautiful Merlot color. So Aurora is a winner in my book. Unfortunately, it doesn't have much fragrance, but it's a knockout in its form and with the flower color. Now let's meet cultivar Rochester. This once was reported to be Hamamelis vernalis, which is the Ozark witch hazel, and studies have shown that it is a hybrid. So ours is labeled Hamamelis Rochester. And what I want you to know about this particular variety is it most definitely has vernalis parentage or blood, so to speak, in it because of the coloration of the petals and also because of its ability to bloom earlier in the year, in the calendar year. And notice the nice orange coloration, which you would tend to find in the straight species of the Ozark witch hazel. What I can tell you about Rochester is that it is one of the earliest blooming witch hazels that we have in the collection, and it is one of the most fragrant. Yes, it does retain last year's foliage. That's something that you definitely need to overlook because this is a plant that gets a lot of foot traffic because of the fragrance. Everybody knows Rochester when they come to the Arboretum. They come to see this particular specimen and they know that it's going to bloom early and be super, super fragrant. So I hope you enjoy this particular variety as much as I do. Now we're in front of one of the common witch hazels. This is Hamamelis virginiana, and it is native to the United States. It is a fall blooming species. So what you're looking at right now is the calyx. This is the part that holds the petals. And there's a funny story behind this particular plant because when I first started working for the Arboretum, I noticed that the plant was in bloom in the fall, but it was labeled Hamamelis vernalis. And the vernalis species, which is the Ozark witch hazel, blooms in midwinter, say January, February into March. And this particular species was, or specimen was, blooming in the fall. So it was labeled incorrectly at the nursery. I've since changed the plant records. Thankfully, mix-ups like this don't happen very often, but it was just a fun find. And when I drive down the road to get to work and pass this particular specimen, I always look over and say, look at you and all your pretty calyx. And so while this plant is not, it's technically not in bloom right now, it does have some interest because of all these pretty colored calyxes. So there are different things to consider when choosing a witch hazel. And one would be the color of the flowers. And so what I can tell you is that with the Hamamelis vernalis, which is the Ozark witch hazel, they generally have flowers that start maybe in the orange range, but then you will find some that go into a russet or a red, and even some purple. And we will see a purple flowered variety shortly. So as you see here, there are multiple types of petal shapes, and they range from twisted or crimped, curled, or straight. Now this, I would say, is, oh boy, a little bit of a straight, maybe a little crimped. And we will see another variety that has extremely long straight petals that is just amazing. So this particular variety is Hamamelis vernalis red imp. It's lightly fragrant. So that's a third thing to consider when selecting a witch hazel, is the fragrance. And I would say there are three different categories for the fragrance, and one being that there is absolutely no fragrance to the flowers. The second would be the astringent aroma, and the astringent aroma is very particular to the fall blooming witch hazel, which is Hamamelis vernalis. And that's where the astringent, the liquid astringent witch hazel, is extracted from. And lastly, then there is a very sweet aroma. And in our collection, some of the most fragrant varieties are Rochester and Gimborne's Perfume and George's. So on a warmer spring day or late winter day, you can smell some of these fragrant flowers from 30, 40 feet away. So with witch hazels blooming in mid or late winter, maybe into very early spring, there's an excellent chance that they will be in bloom for multiple weeks. And that's primarily due to the cool temperatures. The cool temperatures keep the flowers from speeding up their life cycle. And also it's the absence of pollinators. You realize that plants are here to make more copies. And so once a plant has bloomed and has been pollinated, the flower is useless to the plant. In cool temperatures, the pollinators are not present, and therefore the flowers are saying, well, let's hang around for a while because we haven't done our business yet. And that's great for us because you have many weeks of flowering out of beautiful shrubs and even delightful scent for many weeks as well. So let me introduce you to a hybrid witch hazel by the name of Antoine Court. So this is Hamamelis X Intermedia Antoine Court. And the Intermedia indicates that it's a hybrid of two very, very good species, Hamamelis mollis, which is the Chinese witch hazel, and Hamamelis japonica, which is the Japanese witch hazel. And with those two crosses, you get the fragrance of the Hamamelis mollis crossed with long petals of the Hamamelis japonica. Now, what is wonderful about Antoine Court is, well, really everything. Look at the beautiful vase shape, and there are approximately 6 or 7 different habits or shapes of witch hazels, from weeping to, gosh, upright, vase-shaped, ball-shaped. We have a lot that seem to be more on the vase-shaped side, and I really like this form. Another thing that I love about Antoine Court is the multicolored flower petals. See how they start in a nice light orange at the tip, and then it progresses towards a nice raspberry color. And once again, there's that colorful calyx, which is a beautiful Merlot. Witch hazels also tend to hold their fruit capsules or their seed capsules through the spring. And a cool thing is they're interesting in shape, but they are dehiscent. And so dehiscent means that they generally shoot out, or these capsules shoot out the seeds. And sometimes you can hear the seeds hitting the ground or hitting other leaves. It's a little startling at first, but once you realize what that sound is, it's really very comical. So I hope you like Antoine Court as much as I do. I have a really happy story about all of this construction and our witch hazel collection. So several years ago, when Singer Hall was being constructed and Martin Hall behind me was still being considered as being refurbished and renovated, we were given the opportunity to move specimens that might be in the way of construction activities. And in this very location, there were four different beautiful specimens that were in the way of the wrecking ball, so to speak. And I'm really, really happy to report that all of them were hand dug and moved to different locations in the Arboretum, and they are thriving. So here are photos from approximately 3 years ago showing one of the very large witch hazels that was right in the center here being hand dug by a landscape contractor and moved over near the Arboretum office. Another delightfully fragrant Ozark witch hazel is Lansing. What I really love about this plant is the location. Look at how it's backlit beautifully, and that's something that I encourage you to consider when you add witch hazels to your landscape. So I encourage you to break the rules and either use your witch hazels as single standalone specimens, or maybe group them in threes, but mix the colors and or mix the bloom times so that you have, say, a yellow that starts blooming in January, and that could be Wisley Supreme is one that blooms at that time. And then you have Lansing, which is blooming now, so we are in mid-February. And then add one of the Japonica hybrids, because the Japonicas are later blooming. And so you have succession of bloom and different color flowers. Lansing is also fragrant. The petal length is not that long, but notice how the flowers are very, very clustered. And once again, that beautiful Merlot color calyx adds a little oomph to the flower. Also, notice the location that this plant is growing in. There's high shade, and I have to tell you, witch hazels are generally found on a woodland edge, but they tend to be a little bit more rangy in their habit. And if you want a very full appearance to your plant, then I would recommend that you plant them in full sun. That's where we have the vast majority of our specimens. And the soil should be free draining with a pH of anywhere from 6.5 down to 4.5. During periods of drought, we do hand water these. And many of the varieties of witch hazels, not only in our collection, but available in the trade, have monumental fall color for the foliage. So that's another thing to consider. I would say witch hazels serve many, many purposes, not only for the form and fragrance and color of the flowers, but their ease to grow. And then, of course, the fall color. And here we have a hybrid called Westersteed. I love this color. It is so strong, and the flowers are fragrant. Don't you like how this just lights up beautifully in the sun? And it photographs really well. I tend to photograph witch hazels on a sunny day so that I can capture the petals being backlit. Right behind it is a very unique variety. This is another hybrid, so this is the X Intermedia. variety or species. And so once again, that's a cross between Hamamelis mollis and Hamamelis japonica. This variety is called Strawberries and Cream. Either you hate it or you love it, and I love it because of the name and the flowers. I just love the flower color here. Once again, starts out very light at the tip, and as you progress down into the calyx, it goes to a raspberry color. And also, these petals are longer than some that we've seen, even with the Westersteed that we just saw. And so I would call this petal shape crinkled, but it's a really cool plant. And then, just to give you a little inside information, we are going to have this particular Strawberries and Cream specimen dug very, very shortly and relocated because we found that the color is not playing nicely with the other witch hazels in this grouping here. And it's a little off, it's a little soft, and doesn't quite fit with the very, very bold yellow. So I'm sure you agree with me, and that's a good thing, because we've been considering moving this witch hazel for quite a long time, and it's getting done this March. And like I've mentioned before, we've had great success with relocating our witch hazels, and so this will go in a very special location and be a standalone specimen. Here we have another native species, and this is Hamamelis ovalis, which was recently discovered, or recent as in 2004-2005, in a very limited range in the southeastern part of the United States. The common name is bigleaf witch hazel, and so the leaves are a little bit larger than other witch hazel species. Don't you just love this color? And also, being that it's backlit right now, it's just dynamic. So we have large groupings of witch hazels in three locations, with some outlying plants in different locations, but one location is near the Women's Resource Center, where we are right now, and I want you to see the variety called Primavera. This has been in flower for a long time. This started about 4 weeks ago, and the flowers are holding beautifully because of the cooler weather, and right beyond it is Early Bright, which is another early blooming variety. And let's go see if it's fragrant. Yellow is a wonderful color, especially in the wintertime. Don't you agree? This has a very light astringent fragrance to it. And look at the hundreds of flowers. Chinese witch hazel called Imperialis. And I highly recommend it for several reasons. And one is the color, but the other is the long petal. These are very straight petals, but look at how they're probably an inch long. And this has been in bloom for approximately 4 weeks. So what a wonderful variety. This is a standalone specimen, but also it shows up very well because there's a green background behind it. So that's another thing to consider when citing your witch hazel. What is the background, and is it full sun? If it's a very fragrant variety, try to put it close to a path so that as you walk by on a warmer winter day, the aroma wafts up to you, or that the plant is accessible where you could go over and enjoy it. This is variety Birgit, and this particular plant is near and dear to my heart because it was one that was in a construction zone and was hand dug by some very committed hardworking landscape contractors, and then brought over to this location, which is behind the Arboretum office. And 2 years later, it's thriving, doing very, very well. The flowers are crinkled and a beautiful cranberry color. This would look so much nicer if we were filming where the sun was backlighting the flowers, but I hope you can appreciate the color as you see them right now. And come visit Birgit, because she is a success story. I tend to be attracted to witch hazels that have orange flowers. This one is the exception. I am really enamored by this mulberry colored variety of a Japanese witch hazel. And I wish that this was backlit right now, but even when it's not, you can see how rich the color is, and then Can you imagine what it looks like in full sun? How do you like hybrid witch hazel called Sweet Sunshine? This is a doll, not only because it's in a very protected location and it surprises you when you come around the corner of the bed and, ooh, here's this beautiful yellow variety, but it has abundant petals and it's fragrant. So the other day when it was approximately 45, 47 degrees here in the afternoon, I could smell these flowers from 50 feet away. And notice the beautiful green backdrop for it. So single specimen, bright yellow, fragrant, Sweet Sunshine is a winner. Now many of the witch hazel varieties and or straight species grow anywhere from 8 to maybe 15 feet tall, more like 8 to 12 feet tall. If you're limited with space in your garden, then try Quasimodo. And Quasimodo is one of the Ozark witch hazels. It tends to max out at about 5 feet in height. So it's cute. The flowers are very, very small. They are very, very lightly fragrant, more astringent. So it has abundant flowers, but the petals are very short. And I would say the redeeming quality of this particular cultivar is its compact size. So here we have a purple variety of Hamamelis vernalis. And this particular one is trade name, Grape Fizz. So if you notice, the petals are not that long, but it's the color. It's rather muted. And so, as I mentioned, Hamamelis vernalis tends to be, or the flowers tend to be more of an orange. They can be a little bit reddish or maybe a bronze color. And then one of the last colors in the color range would be this plum. And I can't say that this is really stunning, not only because the flower petals are small, but the color is just very muted and very drab. So think about that before you add one of the purple varieties of the Ozark witch hazel to your collection. You're not going to get a super big wow factor out of the purple flowering kinds, but it's nice that we have this in the collection, and it's a really good example of the color range of Hamamelis vernalis. Well, friends, I must wrap this up, and it's been a delight being able to talk to you about one of my favorite collections here at the Scott Arboretum. Please come visit us. We are open free of charge 365 days of year from dawn until dusk. And don't forget to check out Arboretum Explorer, which will help you navigate to all of our woody plants. So trees, shrubs, and vines. And also you can look up dedicated trees and dedicated benches as well.